Hey guys, it's me, Storm's Bunnies, and today we are looking at Sons of the Forest. My version is probably not the most latest version that everyone else has, because mine is the pirated version. And yeah, I'm looking to play this more on the PlayStation 5 when it does come out, which shouldn't be too far away, hopefully. And I do understand and respect that it may take up to a year for it to come out on PlayStation 5. But let's get straight to it, eh? Yeah. Go to multiplayer, host, continue. So I've played a bit of this and got a custom game set up, where I've sort of adjusted things for my own sort of liking, and personally I feel that the enemies are a bit OP, or that they were in the previous version that I did have, since I now have updated to a slightly newer version, I guess, or updated version. But I just felt the enemies were just OP, as I said, and I wouldn't mind seeing maybe like an easy sort of mode, put it. However, I've completed the forest, and it's probably, comparable to as hard as that was. Yes, I have been doing the electrification glitch, and yes, I have built on the lake. I haven't done much building on the lake, but I'll show you what I've got done. There's just a few things I probably needed to do before winter ended. Big Ed mode. Always looks funny. Alright, I suppose let's get some logs duplicated, eh? Kells, mate, what are you doing? You're just gonna sit there, chill out, or should I give him an instruction? Yeah. Get me some fish, mate. Yeah, just drop it here, I reckon. Good stuff, Kells. Alrighty. So you might be wondering why I'm doing this, and to put it quite simply, I'm doing this as a way of storing logs. You can put, if you're clever with it, and providing it lets you place it like that, you can put quite a few down and store them down, and they take up a little bit less room than a log holder. So there's that way. Too many sticks. In terms of Jesus, you get stuck on that, but hopefully they fixed that up in the newer update that everyone just got. In terms of taking these logs off from like this, from the build mode, it is a little bit sort of longer than just picking them up out of the log holders. Log carts, we haven't even got a log car yet, but that's probably coming. However, it's not too much of a hassle to to take them off. You just got to hold down square, and it's, saves you a lot of resources on sticks and stuff like that. Okay. Oh, holy crap. He's gotten a little bit better with his fishing skills. Okay. How do I just get rid of that? Can I just equip? Oh, no, I wanted to drop it, you dumbass. Alright, Yeah, well, Change of plan. Kells, mate, you're bloody good at fishing. One thing I'm not too sort of keen on is doing the yeah, not that. Doing the okay, that's why. Doing the log duplication glitch is a bit of a hazard risk, because if you're on top of it, you can sometimes get sort of bounced up into the air really high and then sort of come flying down. Like the other day, I flew all the way down here and it sort of downed me. So it's kind of a health hazard, if you get what I'm saying. Alrighty, get a lot of sticks. Yeah, that still works. Pick up sticks, press circle. Pick up sticks, press circle, and you can carry seemingly infinite amount of sticks. I think they're patching that one out. I don't know. I haven't read the patch notes for the latest hotfix, but yeah. See, just like that, I just flew up into the air, not super high as you just seen, but it's sort of just, yeah, just flicks you up a bit, so you got to be careful of that if you're doing this. 121, your max capacity is 20, for those who don't know. Oh my god, I need to use a stick. Okay, you can only carry two logs at a time, not three. Alrighty. Ah, you dumbass. Sorry. Not thinking. Yep, put the log down. Come on, there we go. Alright, there we go. Got two. Now I'll get four. In a minute, I'm going to destroy that, because I hate doing that. It's a bit of an annoying thing that you just do if you don't get your thing right. But yeah, it's just, yeah, you're duplicating logs. If you don't get the action right, then it's your own fault, I guess. Okay, done. Oh yeah, there we go. There goes one. There we are. What the hell just happened there? Just a controller. Sure. I'm using a PS5 controller for those who are interested. Works alright. Just gotta figure out the sort of, you know, the controls when you're first doing them. It's no different to the PS4 version, really. For anyone interested in, you know, playing on Steam with a controller on that. As I'm not you know, keyboard and mouse orientated, I'm you know, controller configured. Alrighty. So, I guess you're wondering how I'm getting all the logs over there. So, the system I got put in place, and I'll just show you. Oh shit. Okay. Dude. We forgot about you. Take a break. Okay. We've got more fish than we can poke a stick at. He's got like super efficient at fishing, man. Look how many he's fucking got. Hey, there we are. Yeah, just like it there. Why not? In a second, I'll see if I can get Kelvin to follow me over there. Although I'm not sort of expecting it because I don't know if you know if they're going to keep you know allowing us to Jesus Christ build on the water. I could have put stairs there, but I couldn't get these stairs to sort of trigger, you know. For those wondering. Alrighty, so let's get some logs. Now here's how I've been getting them across. Look at that. That's pretty handy. I could go get the rope gun and just zip one across, and I might still do that. But for now, while this method works, you know, I'm not gonna fix what ain't broken, so to speak. Okay. That doesn't matter that it didn't go into the other one, but I would prefer it if it did. Come on, dude. There we go. So yeah, what I'm doing is filling up those log holders. Once they're sort of full, shifting them down to the other log holders and then coming back for more, filling them up and just rinse and repeat. You know, the reason why I'm taking the walls off this for is because ideally you don't need them no more. Like, well, I don't need them no more and I can use them for this. The building, I mean. I want that wall there because it, I think it stops me from falling out the edge there. So I don't particularly feel like falling down there again. I enabled big head mode. If anyone's wondering, just to sort of see if it'll be a little bit easier for me. And also, you know, visually looking for your characters, because sometimes they go a little bit sort of AWOL, you can spot them easier, you know? There we go. That keeps doing that. I think the cable that I'm using for my controller is a bit dodgy. The USB-C cable. Anyway, let's not worry about that. So all I do is just come here, fill up these. Once I got all X amount of log holders filled up, which is like maybe 10 on each side or something like that, I come back and I do some more building. But one thing I've got to try and work out is, and I'll show you in a second, is can I remove additional support beams that are in my structure? Now, some people might say, yes, you can. I haven't worked it out yet because I didn't put in the additional beams on the side that stick out into the ground, or in this case, you know, the frozen lake. And I've just put the standard support beams here. And I've got, you know, a bit of a hallway here, but I can't, you know, remove these ones. And I want to put some stairs in eventually. So for now, I'm just going to, you know, work on doing me walls. And yeah, I'll, you know, do a bit more research on some videos and see if I can do what I wanted to do. Let's go see what Miss Virginia is up to. Floating fire. Nice. Where did she go? She's over there. Why is she over there for? Yeah, let's get a drink. So I've got a bit more stamina. Okay, that's better. Hello, what are you doing? Hey? You gonna come back over to the base with me? Can you walk over this part here? Because I can. I think you can. Let's see if she'll do it. Kelvin seems to avoid water, but he does seem to cross like low level water, you know, parts like this. Well, she's taken a sweet ass time. So, what's she doing? Looks like she's just gonna chill out there. Let's just see if Kelvin will follow us. Because I have seen him come in here before. Although, I don't know if his parking's improved that much. From the version that I had, and the version that I currently updated to, and then, you know, to the version, excuse me, that everyone else has. Kelvin, follow me over here, please. Where is he? No, he's stuck over there. It also probably doesn't help to the fence here. And I'll just tell him to sort of stay hidden. Because he seems to be out of the way a lot less. Is my defensive walls there that I've got? I've put them here, blocking his route along with that thing there. He could probably get past here, but I've noticed that he will not attempt it. Like he's hesitant to do it, and I'm not too sure why that is. It's something to do with his pathing. But, you know, I'm expecting that to be sort of patched and, you know, fixed up soon. Alright, another thing is to remember, is when you were doing the log duplication, be careful that Kelvin or Virginia are not around you, because when the log pops up after you bump it, it can down them pretty much in one hit. So yes, there we go, got rid of that. So yes, and I think one thing that they may do as a way to counter, if they don't patch out the log duplication glitches, is they may put in a tunable where did player do set action? Yes. Did set action cause player to go down? Yes. Then your bondage level with or your bond level, sorry, not bondage, your bond level with Virginia will reset to zero. And she'll run away, and then you've got to wait for her to come back. And speaking on that, I did have her where she was stuck on a lake before, on a wall, and she wouldn't come out. So what I did was, I just went up and started attacking her, trying to free her. I should have known that, she wouldn't be too happy with it, because, you know, at the start, that's what it's about, just sort of, you know, getting to know you on that. And what did end up happening was, the bond level went back to zero, or whatever, you know, whatever state it returns to. But she did not want to be friends with me. And I don't know if I had have waited, longer than I did, whether it would have reset or not. But, ooh, okay. So we just took some damage then. Let's sleep. Not too sure what that that is that we just bring up when we, you know, close the GPS. But yes. It's like a two-way radio of some sort, maybe. I would like to see a stats menu return to this game as well. So then you can sort of keep an eye on what your stats are currently at and what, you know, your stats can go up to. Are you going to take a break or what? Let's just get him to sit down. Kelvin, you can use the chair, mate. No? Okay. He doesn't want it. Alright. That's fine. Okay, I've got to have one out for deduplication. Alright, well that pretty much, wraps up what I'm sort of doing here today. This video isn't, you know, any actual constructive sort of, gameplay. Basically, why I'm playing this version of the Forest on PC for, is one, to learn the building mechanics, as well as the game goes on, so that when it comes out on PlayStation 5, I'm sort of a little bit ahead in that sort of term, and two, you know, just to sort of, something new to play instead of The Forest, because The Forest on PlayStation is pretty damn laggy. So, that will do for today. If you like this video, please leave a like and subscribe. And as always, I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye for now.